Hi, I'm Joanne with Broadcast Sunny, and I'm reviewing the solar phone recharger by Gold Zero. This is the Nomad 7. I'm not getting paid for this review, nor got anything from the company. I doubt they even know I am doing this review.
What's included?
Magnetic to let it hold. Solar panels that faces the sun. Netting that holds all your goodies. I sometimes put the phone in here. Battery. Full charge. Fan attachment. Flashlight attachment. Wire to connect battery. And to connect battery to phone. More wires. This one connects solar panel to battery. This one is to charge a 12 volt device. Now, I never used it. This one, I have no idea. It says guide 10. And then there's an input for the chain input, which connects several solar panels together.
Pros! Number one, it works!
A fully charged battery charges my small phone completely, 100%. However, I just got a new larger phone and it only gives a half charge. It has hooks, so you can attach it to your backpack. It comes with a flashlight attachment. You twist it on, which you don't really have to twist it on all the way, but then you press the button and you have light. Woohoo! And a fan attachment. So the fan comes with two pieces. This is the one attachment, and then you just slip this on. You twist this on again, but I'm not gonna do that. And there's your fan. I've actually never used either of these. I mean, except for to try it out and say, oh, that's cool. But frankly, I just charge my phone with it. Ack!
I like the way it folds. You can hold it up.
I have left this baby out in the rain and it still works. So cons. When the battery is not in use, it loses its charge. It takes a while, but it does. And I think, I'm pretty confident, if you keep it hooked up to the solar panel and the solar panel is not charging, it loses its charge even faster. So I always leave it unplugged. So the panels does superb in direct sunlight. In indirect sunlight, I'm lucky to get a 25% charge from a full day of charging. And then, of course, cloudy, forget about it. In the winter months, even on a completely sunny day without a cloud in the sky, it takes longer to charge. My guess is that it's the angle of the sun hitting the panels. So these are some neutral, but and here's some neutral comments. Take them as you wish. The battery is heavy, like most batteries are, but the panel is quite heavy too. Not really a big deal unless you are a backpacker and weight is important, as it is to me. Last but not least, the instructions say you can connect your phone directly to the panel. But it does warn that the power coming through may be intermittent. So I tried this on a clear summer day. And unfortunately, my phone kept going on and off. When I checked it after just a few minutes, my phone was really hot. It wasn't working. But I found a solution to this. With a small charge, you can hook up
the battery. Right. You hook up the battery. And then once it gets a small charge, you hook up the phone. And that way, the battery's getting the intermittent charge, but the phone is getting a steady charge. It worked. I use it all the time. Huzzah! With my newfound setup, I oftentimes put my solar panel on my dashboard of my car when I am traveling somewhere. It works out great. Hence, I was able to use the battery phone to charge my phone. All in all, I like the purchase, and I'm thinking of getting a second battery, and so I can rotate between the two and always have a charged battery. I am curious about daisy chaining more than one solar panel together, but the panel is quite pricey. I did get it on sale on one of those super deals. But if I ever do get a second one and daisy chain them, I will let you know and I will vlog about it. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.